subscribe to our channel for latest video series on GATE, UGC, NET and more. Also press the bell icon so that you never miss an update on any latest video. For more information, you can visit our website or call on the numbers below. Hello everyone. So we're going to look at some more questions from percentages that we already seen. So you just have a look at this question. It says that there's a sugar solution. So sugar solution is basically going to consist of sugar and water. So they say that the solution is total solution is 300 grams, of which 40% content is sugar, right? And they're asking you that if they want to concentrate the solution, okay, they want the solution to have 50% sugar in it, then how much sugar should be added? See, firstly, I'll tell you what mistakes students are generally committing in this kind of question, right? Then we'll see the right approach. So sometimes in some distraction, what will students do? Initially solution had 40% sugar, right? So initially amount of sugar is 40% of 300 grams, which makes it 120 grams. So initially the solution had 120 gram sugar. Now they want to make it 50%, right? Then what do you do? Required amount defined, 50%. 50% of 300 you find, which is going to be 150 gram, right? And they'll just compare these two values. Initially sugar was 120 gram, required is 150, so we need to add 30 grams, right? And see, in these type of question, first option also you'll find 30 gram, you just stick. So this is wrong. Okay, why is this wrong? Because when you're going to add sugar to the solution, amount of solution is also going to increase. Okay, only sugar is not going to increase. You've mixed two things. You're adding one thing, then the total amount of the solution is also going to increase, right? That is why this is wrong approach. Fine, do not do like this, right? Then what do we do? Suppose you add x grams of sugar to the solution, then what does total amount of sugar become? 120 plus x. But what happens to the solution? It also increases by x grams, right? So total amount of solution also becomes 300 plus x. Now this should be equal to 50%, right? Amount of sugar in this new solution, this should be equal to 50% on by 2. Now clearly you just solve for x. So when you solve this, you're going to get x is going to be equal to 2x minus x is 300, 60 gram. So how much sugar do you need to add? You need to add 60 grams sugar, right? C is going to be the correct option. So we just took this question to tell this approach. This approach should not be followed, okay? This is going to give you wrong answer. Because when you're adding one thing to a solution, then total amount of solution is also going to increase, right? So look at the next question. So they saying that the price of an article was cut by 20%, but then they needed to restore it to its original value. So now they're asking you how much percent should the new price be increased. Fine. See, since they have given us in percentages, also they're asking the answer in percentage. What are we going to do? We assume that price of this commodity was 100 initially. Okay. So we assume, maybe I'll write this. So we assume that initial price was rupees 100. Now when it was cut down by 20%, then the price would have become, so they've cut down the price by 20%, so it would have become 80 rupees. Now they want to, again they want to restore it to the original value, right? They want it to become rupees 100 only. So they have to increase by rupees 20. Fine, they're asking you how much percent, by how much percent you need to increase. So actually you need to find out 20 is how much percent of 80. So 20 by 18, 20. See, why we have taken this to be 80 here? Because they say that new price has to be increased. So you're going to find percentage with reference to the new price only. New price was 80, you needed to increase rupees 20. So this is going to be the percent, required percent. Fine, so the answer is going to be 25%. See, we've seen a question like this before also. Answer is not going to be 20. Okay, why? The price was cut down by 20% to restore. Again, you would think that it has to be increased by 20% only. No. Why? Because see, now we are finding with reference to the new price. Okay, we're not finding with reference to the original price only. If it asked, right, something else, some with reference to original price, maybe answer would have been same. But we now the reference has changed. Now the increase has to be there on the new price on rupees 80. That is why it has to be increased by 25%. Right, so now look at this question. So they're given that price of sugar increased by 20% and as a result a family decreased its consumption by 25%. So they're asking you that the expenditure of family on sugar decreased by how much. So we know that what is expenditure going to be. Expenditure is actually going to be price of a commodity into consumption. Right, it's going to be the product of these two things. So since they're asking in percentages only, so it's better you consider initially price was 100, also consumption was 100. Then what would have been expenditure? Expenditure would have been 10,000. So initially this was the case. Now what happened? Price increased by 20%, which means price became 120. Consumption decreased by 25%, which means consumption became 75. Now this is, what is this equal to? This is equal to 9,000. Right, which means that initially expenditure was 10,000, now it has become 9,000. They're asking you the percentage. So percentage decrease. So clearly you can see that the expenditure has decreased, right? It has decreased from 10,000 to 9,000. What is the percentage decrease going to be? 1,000 decrease has happened on this price, right? Because initially they were having consumption of 10,000. So expenditure. This is going to be 10%. So the answer to this question is going to be 10%. See, considering some values to be 100 is going to help you a lot in this topic of percentages, because your calculating percentages in 100 makes it very easy. 20% increase means just add 20. 25% decrease means just subtract 25, right? So this makes calculations easier. Plus, calculating percentages with the base of 10,000 with the denominator of 10,000 is also very easy, right? Things get cancelled out. So I'd say that that whenever you get a question from percentages, better you assume some values that makes your calculation easier, right? Right, so now let us have a look at the next question. So they're talking about a rectangle. They say that the length of the rectangle was increased by 60%, but they do not want to change the area. They want the area of the rectangle to remain same. Then what changes must be made to the width? See, if length is increased and area does not have to change, then width has to be decreased. So they're asking how much percent should the width be decreased. So I assume that initially length was L, right? And the width was B, width or breadth, whatever you say. Right, so this has to be equal to the new area. Now what is the new area going to be? Length increased by 60% means new length is going to be 1.6L. 60% increase in L is going to give us 1.6L, right? And suppose we assume that width was decreased by some x percent. So this is going to be 1 minus x percent into B. Now this B and L cancel out, which gives us 1 minus x upon 100 is going to be equal to 1 by 1.6. So if you just solve it, you're going to get 75 by 4. Or if you find this, I guess it is going to be 1. Fine, so this is going to be the answer. Okay, so little mistake here. This is going to be 2, and so answer is going to be 75 by 2, or you can say 37, 1 by 2%. Fine, just little cancellation mistake I've done. Fine, so this is going to be the answer. So if length is increased by 60%, breadth needs to be decreased by 37, 1 by 2%, such that area of the rectangle remains same. Okay, so this is the last question that we're covering from this topic. Right, look at, have a look. So they're saying that there's a sphere of radius 10 centimeter and they're asking you to find that what percent of its volume is its surface area. So basically they're checking knowledge of your formula. So if you remember, surface area of sphere, right, so maybe some of you might not know this, surface area of sphere is going to be equal to 4 pi r square, right, and volume of sphere, you can just remember these, volume of sphere is going to be 4 by 3 pi r cube, right, so they need you to find that surface area is what percentage of the volume, right, so they need you to find this ratio. Now if you just put in the values, surface area is going to be 4 pi r square, volume is going to be 4 by 3 pi r cube, pi cancels out, 4 cancels out, r square is going to cancel out, right, so this has become 3 by r into 100. Now they've given you the value of its radius, it's 10 centimeters, so you just put the value and you get that this is going to be 30%. Fine, so this basically just we took this question to see this formula and solve. Okay, so the answer is going to be 30%. So we've covered, I guess we have covered all the models of question that have been asked from percentages, all the concepts, everything. It's over from my side. Anyway, if you find any questions, any topics, anything that you think that has not been covered, so you can just leave that in comments. We'll try to make another video and cover all those topics. Any queries you have, you can always ask, right? In the description, you can find contact numbers. If you need full series of these videos, you can just call us or get in touch. Thank you for watching.